I don't think anyone should be all that surprised by this. Don't get me wrong. Last week was a ton of fun getting a win at home against the Ravens on a game in a game where you're trying to honor and celebrate the late, great Jim Donovan. But this Sunday was a major come crashing back down to earth moment. And honestly, I don't want to say I'm glad it happened, because obviously I want the Browns to win every single Sunday. But I am glad the Browns got a glass of cold water splashed in their face right before the NFL trade deadline, so they didn't kid themselves as to what kind of team they are this year. They're not a good team this year. And so with the trade deadline on Tuesday, November 5th, this should reaffirm every belief the Browns have about maybe trading away some of their older veteran players. The Chargers came into Cleveland and beat the crap out of the Browns from start to finish. 27-10, Jameis Winston gave us the true Jameis Winston experience. And honestly, it really wasn't very far off from what we saw last week. He was better last week, don't get me wrong. But the big difference for Jameis this week was the opposing team actually caught the interceptions. Last week, the Ravens dropped three easy picks. This week, the Chargers caught all those passes. So we got the Jameis experience. I don't think anyone should look at this and go, 235, one touchdown, not too bad. No. This Browns offense could not move the ball for the first 55 minutes of the game. I'm not going to let a garbage time touchdown to Cedric Tillman fool or trick me into thinking, it wasn't all that bad for Jameis. It was bad. It was exactly what I've been preaching, and so many of you were so quick to DM me about before Watson went down, which is insert Jameis, and I don't think it's any different. Was it any different? They had 3 points for 54 minutes. 58 minutes. 59 minutes. The offense is still not good. The defense, I mean, we joke about, here's Joe Woods again. Guys, Joe Woods has been gone for a long time now. There's one constant, the personnel. I think there's a fair amount of blame that has to get placed on a combination of Denzel Ward and Warren Thornhill. Not once, but twice in the same game. Receivers are running wide open. The only good thing that came out of this game was Myles Garrett is still a freak. I mean, there was a moment where Myles Garrett got Joe Alt, who is 6'8", about nearly 300 pounds, and he got him on one leg playing like hopscotch. That's how awesome Myles Garrett is. But yeah, the Browns offense, it still stinks. It stunk before, it stinks now, and changing the quarterback really didn't change anything. You did get the one game boost. I'm a big believer of you get the interim head coach boost. We saw Jeff Saturday come in and beat the Raiders off his couch. And then you get the backup quarterback boost, which is you get the backup out there and everyone plays a little bit harder to kind of pick up the slack for the backup. But after a week, that wears off. Chargers came in and had their way at the Browns at the line of scrimmage for the most part. I mean, the Browns' defensive line had some really good plays and some good moments, but ultimately the Chargers were able to run the ball when they wanted to, and the Chargers' defensive line was wreaking havoc for much of the game. So, what happens next for the Browns? Za'Darius Smith is a Detroit Lion. I didn't watch too closely in the fourth quarter to, you know, keep tabs on every player's snap counts, but hopefully they just shut down Za'Darius Smith in the second half to avoid injury. But Za'Darius Smith is a Detroit Lion. I've been saying that for a month now on the channel. And Shelby Harris should get traded. I like both these players, but they can both give you good draft picks. And this is a team that's going nowhere. They're 2-7. The season's done. I mean, they can win out and be 10-7. If they lose one game at 9-8, that may not be enough to get you in the playoffs. It wasn't last year. So that's truly how much their backs are against the wall right now. Their options are win out to make the playoffs, more or less. So trade Za'Darius Smith and Shelby Harris. Those are two guys who are 32-plus years old. Harris signed a two-year contract. Za'Darius Smith definitely signed a two-year contract. But either way, you trade both those players. If you can get a fourth-round pick for Za'Darius Smith, awesome. If you can get a sixth-round pick for Shelby Harris, cool beans. And you have a third, a fourth, and a sixth added to your draft arsenal for Cooper, Smith, and Harris. Three guys all over the age of 30. It's making the best of a bad situation. I would like to see both those trades happen. Other guys that could get moved, maybe Elijah Moore. He's on an expiring contract, but the Browns may want to keep him because they may want to bring him back after all. So that's one name to watch for. If anyone wants Jed Wills, have at it. I really doubt anyone does. And remember, you can't just trade away the player you don't like because he's not good. Who's going to trade for that guy? If you were a Browns fan, would you want to trade for another team's Jed Wills? Probably not. But those two trades, I think, are absolute minimums. Za'Darius Smith and Shelby Harris. The Harris one, I'm not quite sure where his market is, but if you can get a day three pick swap, I would do it. It gets Mike Hall on the field more. Give your rookie some more snaps the rest of the way. Give him an opportunity to really grow this season. Nick Chubb is just not here. 15 carries, 39 yards. He had one good 11-yard run, but doesn't look like he has that speed he had before the injury. And he's struggling with breaking contact and ripping off longer runs like we're used to seeing. Hopefully that comes with more time, but it's not good so far. That's the tough pill to swallow. Tillman, though, here's some good news. Like, that touchdown, even though it was garbage, it was still a very good play. Like, it was still a play that he made, that he put on film, that he can make in terms of tightrope walking in the side of the end zone. Six grabs, 75 yards, and a touchdown. So it's nice to see Tillman put together three straight good outings. And the Browns hopefully have something young at that position to build for it or build off of in the future with Cooper gone. And the only other receivers under contract for next year are Tillman, Jerry Jeudy, David Bell, and Jamari Thrash. So this gives you a nice start at that wide receiver spot. And Njoku was his usual self today. That's not quite true. Five grabs, 29 yards, not his usual self. We just didn't see any explosive plays from anyone on the Browns offense. I mean, CBS put on a graphic halfway or towards the end of the game that showed the explosive plays by the Chargers and by the Browns, and it was like 7-1. So that kind of sums up how the offenses went for both sides today. Next up, I'm going to show the defense a new one. But first, a quick shout-out to our sponsor, Leaf Filter. Leaf Filter has been protecting gutters in Northeast Ohio for nearly 20 years. As the official gutter guard of the Cleveland Browns, Leaf Filter has a limited-time offer for Browns fans. Up to 32% off your entire qualified purchase and two free official Browns jerseys at leaffilter.com/report. An investment in Leaf Filter is an investment engineered to protect your whole home. Clogged gutters aren't just a nuisance. They can cause extensive water damage, and do-it-yourself and store-bought solutions may be cheaper up front, but can cost you more in the long run. Every installation comes with a lifetime no clogs guarantee, so let Leaf Filter's trusted pro handle it. Call today to schedule your free gutter inspection and get a no-obligation free estimate. A Leaf Filter trusted pro will clean out, realign, and seal your gutters before installing Leaf Filter. Schedule your free inspection now, and for a limited time, get up to 32% off your entire qualified purchase and two free Browns jerseys at leaffilter.com/report. That's a free inspection, up to 32% off, and two free Browns jerseys with qualified purchase at leaffilter.com/report. Offer valid on a first-come, first-served basis while supplies last. Full terms and conditions can be found at leaffilter.com/report. See representatives for warranty details. When Jim Harbaugh is using the second half to just run practice for his passing game, as a defense, you know you have failed in the first half miserably. Like Jim Harbaugh, someone who loves to run the football, and when he's up 20-3 in the second half late, he's trotting out his offense to just throw it around a little bit. He's clearly looking at this like a training camp practice, a training camp scrimmage. That's what he thought of the Browns defense. But more importantly, that's what he thought about the Browns offense to make any kind of comeback attempt. Herbert diced up the Browns in the first half. I think he had 240 yards at halftime. Then they were able to kind of put it in neutral for the second half and coast on in for a nice victory. What a good week for me to bench J.K. Dobbins, by the way, in fantasy. 85 carries for 85 yards and two touchdowns. It wasn't even like the Browns' run defense was so bad today. It was just this Browns defense was giving up huge explosive plays at costly times. Two long touchdown passes, one to Quentin Johnston, one to Joshua Palmer. Johnston, by the way, who is known for drops, four grabs, 118 yards, and a touchdown. Rookie Ladd McConkey was embarrassing you over the middle. The Browns were missing Jordan Hicks and JOK, their two starting linebackers. But all three phases failed today. Offense failed, defense failed, special teams failed. It was so poetic, too, that when you're down 20-3, of course, a 51-yard field goal from Dustin Hopkins is not just blocked, it's blocked by a Chargers defender's nipple. That's how low of a kick it was. He got his hand up, and he didn't even need to. It would hit him right here. It was that kind of day for the Browns, but it's not like we can just chalk it up to a bad day for the Browns. Nope, just another bad week for the Browns in what's been a season of a lot of bad weeks. This is why I had the unpopular opinion the last couple of days and over the last week of the Browns should still be sellers, because you guys were all trying to tell me, hey, playoffs, 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 and sure, it's fun to live in that world, but this team has never looked like a playoff team outside of one week against Baltimore. So you're telling me when they played eight, nine games, we should look at one win over the Ravens and say, yeah, that one win, that tells us more about this team than the other seven games. I'm somewhat relieved the Browns didn't trick themselves into thinking they were a legitimate playoff team with a win today. At 2-7, sell. You don't trade Myles Garrett. You don't trade Denzel Ward. The only guys that are kind of on the fence for me, if you get a second-round draft pick for David Njoku, I would do that trade. I like Njoku a lot, but clearly this team needs to get young because they're old and bad, and that's the worst thing to be. If you're young and bad, okay, we're growing. If you're old and good, you got a window. If you're young and good, you got something building for the future. If you're old and bad, oh, that's the worst combination, and that's what they are right now. It's one of the oldest rosters in the NFL. Have to be sellers. Not one player. Everyone should be taking phone calls with the exception of Myles Garrett, Nick Chubb, Denzel Ward, and JOK. Those are probably the only players who are untouchable for me. Everyone else has a price. Make sure to subscribe. We're not going to stop our coverage. So if you're looking for a Browns YouTube channel that's dedicated for the entire season, the entire year, all 365 days, hit that sub button down below.